Okay, if what the prosecutors and judges do in these anti-corruption cases is irreversible, as I said in the campaign, that's a matter of death and life. At the level of these prosecutors and these judges, they will not change. Nothing will change them. However, as I said, and I will repeat, the people are, the heads are important. For instance, the current general prosecutor was appointed by the prime minister from the Socialist Party, but a party which never fought against corruption. And actually, one of the ministers in this campaign was convicted a few days ago for fraud, electoral fraud. And the person he appointed, he negotiated with the previous president. He's a person who did nothing in his career. He's a friend of the prime minister. And therefore, the general prosecutor office is doing no cases. The difference is that the other office, the anti-corruption office, which is independent, including financially, is doing all these cases. So that's what I'm saying. It could be reversible if they succeed to change all these people and to bring their friends. Yes. I hope this will not happen. But yes, it's possible.
The presidential election was the crucial point.
Okay, but still I want to see, for instance, next year, the mandate of the current chair of the chief prosecutor of the anti-corruption prosecutor office expires. This is Kövesi. It's very important who will be there.
We're supposed to appoint the next.
The proposal will be made, as I told you before, by the Minister of Justice. An interview with the Supreme House of Magistracy, an opinion, and then the President. And let's see the President what will do. Last week, he appointed a person as the head of the organized crime department. It was not really coming from Iași, if you know about the city. The city is full of crime, so if you... You know, that's another way to measure the quality of the work of prosecutors. You have criminal gangs and activities. Why? And then you pretend that you do your job? No, you don't. You didn't. Because they wouldn't have been created and they wouldn't act if you would have done your job. How many cases you did, how many people you sent to trial, how many investigations you did, how successful they were, everything can be measured in figures. So yes, it's in this way irreversible if they change the heads, and not only the heads, and the heads start to change the prosecutors working. About to take up on the reform of the judicial system in Bulgaria and the European Parliament, fine, I'm happy to do this. And I'm actually working writing on the judicial reform around the countries in the Balkans. It was a question on the threshold of illicit enrichment in Romania. In Romania, I could not enforce this illicit enrichment. I think it's a recommendation in the UN Convention Against Corruption. By contrary, I could do it in Macedonia. So after I had to leave the government after the accession, I was hired by the Foreign Office of the British government to work as an advisor and anti-corruption advisor to the Prime Minister of Macedonia. And there I put I changed the criminal code and I put as a crime in city enrichment in Macedonia. But I have to tell you that Macedonia, for instance, it had before I was there. You can solve this through the taxes. For people who do not declare their taxes, their income, and they don't pay taxes on all their assets, the tax, if they catch you, is 70% of the value of the good. Otherwise, it's 10%.
How about the system problem in Macedonia later, last month?
I'm not commenting on
Macedonia. We don't have to
And also I know that it's a distributed market in Macedonia, so I don't want to go into this. Anonymous signals, sure. We use them, I use them. And if we, I can tell you a nice story, I used them in the European Parliament as well. I had the whistleblower. People working in the European institutions want to keep their jobs because they are European civil servants with good salaries for life. And it's logical they want to keep their job. On the other hand, if they see illegalities in the institutions, they want to tell. If they tell publicly, they risk that they lose their jobs. You know, they make your life miserable, they move you to another place, and so on and so forth. So I was in a situation when I received emails on my official email from, you know, I don't know, anonymous email, asking for my personal telephone or email address I gave. I didn't know who they were. And they tested me, I had three cases. Each asked me to hide a different telephone for each of them. And they tested me for some months, and I'll just give you one example. At some point, they give me good hints to go. At some point, I said, okay, we need to meet, because you tell me about these subcontracts, and I don't have them, and I can't find them. There are subcontracts proving that basically the contract the money went to the director of that institution. So we need to meet. And they said, okay, we'll let you know how we meet. So one day I received an SMS saying that on Thursday, it was Tuesday, on Thursday, I have to be, to go to this country, I'll not say the country, by plane, then to rent a car, then to go to this lake, then to park the car in this parking, then to go to the lake through the alley, which is called this way, through the forest. Then I arrive at the lake. There is an electricity
fence.
Steep, yeah. Then you count three benches to the left and you sit on the third bench.
Wow.
At 9 o'clock in the evening alone.
Oh, like in a movie.
Like in a movie. I believe, like in a movie. Because they followed me all this time, they wanted to make sure that I'm not followed. And they are head of offices in their institutions. Okay, the person came with his for wife and husband. They took me to their home. I slept there, they gave me all the documents, and the director is not a director any longer. Yes, this is like in a movie. I said, I had three situations, I'm just giving one. You have other colleagues to this, not all of them in the European Parliament, but we know that we work like this, and people don't ask, you know, where you get this. I have a source, that's it. They're not allowed to ask me, or if they ask me, I don't say it. They're very afraid that I'm going to tell their names. No, I don't have to tell their names. But that's also part of life, you take risk, as I said. Prosecutor is part of the executive or part of the judiciary. It's part of the judiciary. In 91, when we did our new constitution, they're part of the judiciary, but they are both called magistrates. Now, in terms of how I feel, I think the good system and the real system in a democracy is that the prosecutors are representative of the state. They are subordinated, like in Germany, like in the US, to the general prosecutor, but they have independence on the case. And they represent the interest of the state, the same as the private lawyers, defending lawyers represent the interest of the client. Now, in our countries, after the communists, this system would not have worked. Would not have worked because we wanted to take them out, you know, to take them from the power of the executive, which was for 50 years, or the prosecutors and judges. So this is why you made an independent. Basically, the same way as judges. So that's a solution for the time being in our countries. I don't know if you realize, but we're not in the history. We try to do reforms in all areas, democracy, market economy, judiciary, health, whatever, financially first. In 20 years, or 25 years, or 15 years, reforms which other countries did in hundreds of years. Accession to NATO and accession to EU, to-do list. We want to join NATO, we have a to-do list. Very good. To-do list moved us forward. Want to join the EU? Here is the to-do list. Now, this shortened the history for us. It was a political decision for the two countries to be taken into the EU. You knew that we didn't fulfill all the criteria, but you expected us to continue to the reforms. And that was the tragedy, that we didn't. The politicians didn't continue the reforms. That's why I said, fortunately, the CPM. Now, about independence, again, it can be written in the Constitution, it can be written in the law. This doesn't mean that in reality, because it's written in the law or in the Constitution, prosecutors and judges automatically, all of them will behave independently. Even if they have all the guarantees, they are appointed for life, for instance, in Romania. For life, yes, no one can do anything against them. And still, they don't behave like agents of the person, you know, delivering justice. Not all of them. Young prosecutors or young judges, they are more corrupted. You see, the amounts are growing up as they are younger. It's incredible. We felt that, okay, young generation is not enough to be young. No. So, what I want to speak is about personal independence. If it's in the law, it will not help. If a person is corrupt, will be corrupt. Even if it's in the law that it's independent, it's appointed for life and so on. It's personal independence. This is why I say not anyone can be judge and prosecutor. There are a lot of tests to testing, a lot of systems to test this. It's not so complicated. So it's about personal independence, and this is why I insist it can be done. Just have a prosecutor or two prosecutors to start investigations. That's the question. Oh, about the Prime Minister. I didn't use those words about the Prime Minister. I said, I don't think there is, as it won't be the case in Romania as well. It will be the case in Romania as well. That I will not be the Minister of Justice in Bulgaria, and I will not be in Romania because the political class don't want to be investigated. You know? He didn't know at the beginning who I was and what I was going to do. Now, the second time it won't work like this with me, maybe someone else. So that's why I said that. You know, I can work with anyone. And I work with people who, you know, who shouted at me and threatened me. I don't care if I have an objective, and I don't have any fear. So yes, if it's real, if it's for real, then yes, I come. But they will not ask, that's my point. They will not ask me in Romania. They don't want it once again. That's my question.